this service when you have installed them as your pastor. Needless to say, I have prayed for this day for months, and I'm overwhelmed to be here, but I'm also thrilled that God has chosen through you this wonderful man to serve as your pastor. When David shared a story, that's what retired pastors do. We talk about, previous times, and that's okay, right? So, when Bill served as pastor at Round Rock, he participated in my service of ordination, as were Mike and Joyce at our sponsor church, First Presbyterian Church. Bill also participated in the charter service for this church, also did Mike and Joyce, also at our sponsor church, First Presbyterian Church. But Bill's part in that service was to install me as the first pastor of this newly chartered church. So there are beautiful ways that it all comes together. Bill has been a friend and a colleague for years, but he was also a mentor. He and Doug Doglish led a study group for new pastors, and I was blessed to participate in that. The San Gabriel Steering Committee and then the session went over to Round Rock numerous times to ask for their advice, whether it was about building your sound systems or planning and much more. Based on my experience and observation, you've called an outstanding pastor, and I look forward to seeing what happens in Christ with you all. My first charge to the congregation simply asks you to carry out day after day what you answered in those constitutional questions, to listen to his preaching. That means no falling asleep. Respecting his decisions, welcoming his pastoral care, honoring his authority, following him. I know that the transition has been long. I know that many of you had to step up and provide leadership, but now you have a pastor supporting, following. Be with him, encourage him. So my first charge is to do what you said you would do. Support, encourage, and follow Bill as your pastor. I also ask that you support Bill as a husband, father, friend, and family member. It was good to see Barbara after many years. Barbara and I actually attended seminary together, I think when she was pregnant with you. And I know that my son never liked to hear these stories. Now, I also understand that Addie's at Austin College, where my son attended, thank God. And I know there's some other go-roos here, because there they are. So, except you just did, okay, I almost did the hook and horns instead of the go-roos. Sorry. But when Bill wants that visit from Sarah from North Carolina to go up there or to have her come here, when he wants to be with his family, I know this congregation is going to support him, because you literally helped me raise my son, marry him off, and baptize the kids. Now, they are not asking for some of that support, just a little bit. But they will appreciate, I know, your support and your prayers. When a pastor receives a new call, especially one across the country, the family is right there with them, but it's tough. They have gone through multiple transitions during this past year. I mean, I remember crying all the way back from dropping John off at Austin College. These are some big deals that you've been through, and this congregation gets it. And so my second charge is that you respect and follow Bill, but that you also support and pray for his family. Now, the third charge relates to the stories I said earlier about Mike and Bill and Joyce being present. This church wouldn't be here, not the congregation, not the building, not anything about us, without the support of our sponsor church, but also the support of other churches, Round Rock Presbyterian, Grace in Round Rock, Hope and Covenant, and on, Mission Presbytery as a whole. Remember your connections. We are better together. But we literally, this congregation would not have existed without the ongoing support. I've been serving as chair of the Church Development Evangelism Committee, and I will tell you, Mike, that I have not seen a better, more effective sponsor of a new church development than First Presbyterian Church in Georgetown. I wish we had more, but thank you. And the way this congregation can give back is to do exactly that. I love seeing your elders and Bill at the presbytery. I know that you continue to support the presbytery and presbytery organizations. Thank you. But they also could learn from you. And you also can serve and offer your time and talents in other ways. I know that you, I saw the Stephen Ministry sign. I bet you're partnering with First Pres and others on Stephen Ministry. And I look forward to, I have not been a meddling retired pastor, Sally Watson, who is our gym presbyter, who's here. And so I really don't know all you've been doing, but I've seen some of you at Emmaus, and I bet you're still mucking around in Christ's work with other churches here in Georgetown. Keep it up. We are better together. So my charge then to you is to strengthen your connections with Mission Presbytery and the larger church as you serve Christ, because we really are better together. And my last and fourth charge relates to Bill Poe's wonderful sermon about reversing Babel. This congregation is incredibly diverse, and that is a strength. It has been from the beginning. But it also can be a challenge. I remember as a working pastor thinking that I could bring us to a consensus about how to celebrate communion. I remember someone having a strategy to deal with the conflict by saying, do what you think is best and ask for forgiveness later. Good luck with that one, but I think we cross that way. It is tough sometimes with disagreements, and especially when they get very serious. Disagreements about how the word applies to issues like sexuality or ordination and politics. During my pastor study group with Bill and Doug many years ago, conflict came up many different times, as you can imagine. Bill said that pastors are charged with guiding congregation through inevitable, hear that, inevitable disagreements. We're supposed to listen, we meditate, we gather people around the word, we pray. If disagreements escalate into conflict, Bill warned us, and I remember this vividly, he warned us that the experience is painful for everyone, that it hurts, that there are no winners, that regardless of the outcome, people on all sides of the conflict may decide to leave. But Bill also gave us hope, because he said that congregations are God's vineyard. God will do the pruning. God will also bring new life. In fact, it is the pruning that enables that new life to sprout. So, and Bill, I am so thrilled. You have a pastor with the gifts and experience to guide you in God's mission. So my last charge is that you stay on track with your Missio Dei, the mission of God that you had from the beginning. God wants to send you into the world, and it is a world that has lots of white noise, although I have an app for that, so it helps me sleep. But the world out there, when we had frames on this building, we stuck in prayers that the walls wouldn't keep us from seeing the people. 40% of those folks have no church home, and they desperately need some good news, and you have it to give. God has plans for this church as you move forward with Bill Peterson as your pastor. And God bless you, and I want to say I am thrilled.